Now Joe is not in her. G'day there, Pete Moriarty here, and in this video series, as I've said previously, we are recording quick, short answers to your questions. If you'd like one of your questions answered, just message my page, petermoriarty.tv on Facebook, and I'll be very happy to answer. So in today's question, I'm covering a question from Louise, and that is, well, what backup do I need once I've switched over to G Suite? And this is a great question because we get this question on pretty much every single phone call that we have with any customer who's considering a switch over to G Suite or Google Cloud for all of their business applications. So what do we do? Let's define business backup first. So business backup is gonna be any of your business data that needs to be backed up. So that might be data sitting on local computers. It might be if you still have a server or some kind of local infrastructure hanging around. It might be local servers or local data sitting somewhere there. Number three, you would say that cloud data is gonna be counted in your business backup, right? So something that's within an application like G Suite. It might be Google Drive, might be Gmail, might be Calendar. You can have data in there. And then number four, you may have other applications on the cloud that have business data as well. So for that, it could be something like Xero.com or a business management app that you're using that's browser-based, right? So we've got lots of places where we have business data sitting. Now, how do we make sure that data is actually secured and backed up? So for starters, when you make the switch over to something like G Suite, it's a business platform, right? So you've got your file storage in Google Drive, you've got your calendar data sitting in Calendar, you've got your email sitting inside of Gmail. Ideally, you want to put all of your data inside of the Google ecosystem, because once it's in the Google ecosystem, it's pretty safe, right? It's very unlikely for Google to lose any of your data, considering that it's going to be stored in at least three geographically separate locations at any one time. And so, you know, as long as there's not a nuclear apocalypse or anything like that, you're probably not going to have a data loss event once your data is safely secured inside of Google. So the general rule is, once you have any kind of business data and you've made the switch over to G Suite, the general rule is you want to just put all of that data inside of the Google ecosystem, inside of Drive, upload all your historical emails into Gmail, all that stuff sitting around on maybe a local server, or even if it's sitting in, for example, it might be sitting in on a hard drive or on a USB drive or something like that. All of that archival data, just make sure that's uploaded to Google Drive. That's kind of the first rule, right? And then we kind of worry about backing up Google and how that works. So how do we then back up Google? As I said, Google's storing your data in at least three geographically distributed locations at any one time, right? So it's very unlikely for Google to lose your data. However, there's two events that might make data loss incidences happen or be painful for you, even if you are on G Suite. So one of those may be human error. So human error comes into everything, right? And that looks like this. You're cleaning up your Google Drive. You go and delete a couple of folders. And then 3 months later, you have an oh shit moment and you say, oops, I've cleaned up something that I actually wanted or actually needed, right? By then it's gone out of the trash, right? Because it's more than 30 days. And effectively that data's been lost. So that's gonna be one of the challenges that may pop up. That's the human error element. Now, secondly, if you have something like Google Vault switched on for your domain. So if you're on G Suite Business, you have access to Google Vault. And what that does is it stores a copy of your emails and a copy of your Drive files. So if you delete them, then you can get access to them as well. The challenges with Google Vault is you need to restore them one by one. And the second thing is Google Vault doesn't protect everything in your G Suite account. It does mail and it does Drive. And I think it's doing Hangouts chats now, but it doesn't really do anything else. So Google Vault is useful for backing up some data, and it's more of a e-discovery tool if something goes wrong. So by e-discovery, I mean if you're a legal practice or an accounting firm or in some kind of consulting business and you want to make sure that you have a copy of every communication that's gone in and out of your business and exactly what's been shared with each one of your clients, then Google Vault is great for that because it stores a carbon copy of every single one of your emails in and out of the business safely and securely in the vault, and then it's searchable, right? But that doesn't solve our backup problem. Our backup problem is that, okay, if you delete something, let's say it's a calendar event, and then it's gone, and you're audited 3 years later down the line, and that calendar event is not on your calendar anymore, or maybe it's a staff person, and they've deleted the calendar event, or they've deleted the file, or they've deleted the email, and for some reason it's not there, then you may wish to look at third-party backup options. And that's kind of what the point is here, is that you can get most of the backup done within G Suite, but third-party backup options are where it's at to give you the extra level of protection that you need. Okay, so we've talked about the number one thing that can go wrong, which is human error. The second thing that can go wrong is a crypto locker or ransomware virus. And you may have heard of these. They've, you know, been getting very popular, unfortunately, over the last few years. And what happens there is a virus gets into one of your computers. Could be on a Mac, could be on a PC, and it encrypts all of your files. And once those files are encrypted, you can't decrypt them unless you pay somebody in some weird country a Bitcoin, right? Or something like that. What then happens is effectively every one of your files are held to ransom, which is why it's called ransomware. And we have had customers, we had a law firm that had 30 employees and they didn't opt for a third-party external backup of their Google account or the files that were on their server. And unfortunately, they had to pay thousands and thousands of dollars for this decryption key for that to be decrypted. Now, if you're on G Suite Business and you're using Google Vault, then you might say, well, Pete, doesn't Google Vault protect me from that? If that stores a copy of all my Google files in Google Vault, then does that protect me and does that look after me? Well, not exactly. The challenge is, g'day Neil, the challenge is that when you go to restore files from Google Vault, you need to restore them one by one. So imagine this scenario. You've got 10,000 files sitting in your Google Drive, right? And all of those files become encrypted by a ransomware or crypto locker virus. And it might not even be your computer. It might be one of your staff machines, right? It might be something you don't have control over. And the only way to get them back is to restore them. Now, if you're using Google Vault to restore, you've got to restore each file one by one. Or if you're using the revision history inside of Google Drive, which gives you 30 days of revisions for every file, you've got to restore them one by one. So the only way to have a convenient restoration of those files is to have a third-party backup solution, which gives you one click, and you can do what's called a point-in-time restore. So, quick recap of what we've discussed so far. Number one, if you've got different areas on your computers, online, that you want to have backed up, the idea is that ideally you just want to have everything sitting inside of Google Drive, everything inside the Google ecosystem. That's the safest place for all your data. Third-party, local backup software on your computer that you run a sync every week and you have to plug in a USB hard drive externally, or you're running sync software on your server, that's a mess. Don't even worry about that, right? Get all your data into Google and then let's just worry about backing up Google. Number two, the two types of things that may happen for you to lose data. Number one, maybe human error, someone cleaning things up, thinking they're doing the right thing, but then the files are gone after they've deleted from the bin. Or number two, a ransomware or crypto locker virus that can encrypt all of your files in one go, and it's very difficult if you were to have to restore them one by one. So what's the solution to this? Jack has already, he's beaten us to the punch. The third-party solution that we recommend is called Backupify, and we're a reseller for Backupify. I don't think you can buy it direct, but I don't recommend buying it direct because we resell a different version to the version that you buy direct, because we're one of their top partners in Australia. And when we issue Backupify for your account, what you get is, number one, you get that special point-in-time restore, which means if anything goes wrong with your Google account, if you've got a crypto locker virus, if you've deleted a bunch of stuff a year ago and you've forgotten about it, if you've got malicious damage from one of your staff members, we can click one button and we can automatically restore all of that data inside your Google Drive or Calendar or Gmail or anywhere else within the Google ecosystem. That's really, really great. Number two, we don't need your intervention to do it. We can actually do it from our administration panel, which is pretty cool, which makes it nice and convenient too. If you've got an issue, you just call our support line and you say, hey guys, can you sort this out? But I want to leave you with one final tip. And by the way, if you've got any questions, just go ahead and pop those into the live stream. Happy to answer them. The final tip that I want to leave you with is, what do you do for the files that are on your computer that are outside of Google Drive, right? You've got junk sitting on your desktop. You've got stuff maybe sitting on a server. Yes, maybe you've got things sitting on a USB hard drive. I wouldn't ever recommend that. I don't think there's any scenario where I would recommend that, but maybe you do have data sitting on a hard drive. Louise asked the question specifically, what do I do for that stuff that's still sitting on my computer that's not necessarily sitting in Google Drive? And for that, even though Google have made the transition to Google Drive File Stream, which is a very clever application for synchronizing accessing what's online on Google Drive and getting access to it on your local computer, what that doesn't do is back up your whole local machine. But if you also install what was the old Google Drive app, and it's now called Google Backup and Sync, if you install the Backup and Sync app, that Backup and Sync app can synchronize your desktop folder, your C drive if you really wanted it to, You can synchronize an external USB hard drive. You can synchronize a NAS drive or something that's external to your computer that you've mapped the drive into your computer. Google Backup and Sync effectively just became your cloud backup for all the files on your computer that are outside of Google Drive. And that is super, super helpful. So our key recommendation is for you to use FileStream, right? FileStream covers all of your Google Drive data, all of your data that's sitting inside of Team Drives, and it lets you access that data from your local machine. But if you also want to do a more of a manual backup, backup what's on your desktop, backup what's in your My Documents, backup anything else that's sitting there. For example, if you're running a local database app on your computer, or you're still running MYOB, maybe you've got some local data files that are sitting around there, then Google Backup and Sync can run in conjunction with Google FileStream and have all of that data backed up. There we go. So thanks, Louise, for the question. And if anyone else has questions, just message the page, petermoriarty.tv. Message the Facebook page. I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. And of course, if you would like professional support from our team, we have an amazing community online where we do live training webinars every fortnight. We've got one coming up this Wednesday, and that's in our Cloud Concierge membership. So if you're not already a member, jump on to itgenius.com/CC for Cloud Concierge, or /membership. I think that goes there as well. I'll drop a link below. And that will get you access to all you can eat IT support from our team of professionals, and also, of course, priority with getting your questions answered inside the forum. You get direct access to me as well as the rest of my professional team. Until next time, catch you later. Cheers. I'll